So, welcome to module 7.3. In this module, we will basically describe you the working of the virtual machine. So, we will describe it through different examples. So, to facilitate this, there is a VM emulator tool that is available as a part of your tools. So, just click on that and you will get the VM emulator here, right. Now, here we can load any of these scripts. So, we can just say, let us say we will go to say project 8, let us talk about say program flow, basic loop. There is a basic loop vme.test, load that script, right, and then we can, you can now see how it is going to work. So, now you say push constant 0, essentially your stack pointer is set to 256. Now, you will see that your stack pointer becomes 257, right, pop local 0, right. Right. So, the local variable is set to 16. So, the local variable always starts with 16. So, pop local 0. So, when you see this, that is popped out, and if you go and see the 16th location, this it's 0, right. Then push argument 0. So, argument currently is in 400 in location 400, we really do not know what is this, a stack in location 400, we can just look at this in location 400. We will have 3. So, this is there in location 400, we have been setting it as 3. Okay. So, push argument 0. So, 3 will be now pushed onto the stack, right. Push the content of argument plus 0. Argument is 400 plus 0, in 400 I have 3. So, essentially 3 gets loaded onto this. And push local 0. Local is what? 300. So, what is there in 300? As you see, 0 is there. So, if you just push local 0, basically you get 0. But your stack pointer has increased to 258. Now, we are adding this, 0 plus 3 will be giving you 3, the stack pointer will become 257. Now, pop local 0. So, this 3 basically now gets popped into local plus 0, that is 300 plus 0. So, that right, push argument 0 again, you are pushing 3. Push constant 1, subtract, so this becomes 2, pop it to argument 0, pop, push it, push again argument 0, again you get 2. If the top of the stack is non-zero, go to null loop and start, so you go back there, and this is how it goes. So, for all the instructions one by one, we can just run all these codes. So, we have this vme.tst for every directory, and you can run that to understand how these different codes are executing. So, this is one facility for you to appreciate the working of the virtual machine emulator, and they essentially understand how the virtual machine works. So you can basically use this VM emulator to do this and understand the different instructions. You will now meet now in module 7.4.